All right, y'all, man. On tonight's show, we're going to be talking about the traveling tricks. And we're going to be talking about some other stuff, man. Come on, man. We're going to be chopping up the game on tonight's show, man. It's Player Talk Radio. Let's get it, man. It's DJ Kuda. If you have any questions, you can email me at playertalk8@gmail.com. That's playertalk8@gmail.com. Also, if you would like to be on the show, you can email me at playertalktv@gmail.com. That is playertalktv@gmail.com, man. Come on in, man. Let's get into this game. Let's go. Let's get it, man.
You know me, I keep the gutter. Till you stutter, then she got to answer me questions like she was undercover. Like who was that little chick that I let ride up in my ride? I'm a pimp, so it ain't nothing for me to think of a lie. But I'd rather keep it real and tell her just how I feel. Look at here, if you see me with another chick, then it's just what it is. You ain't my main vein, I just out the frame. Baby, I'm Hurricane. You gotta stay in your lane. Stick to the script of a pimp and follow my gutter rules. And if you feel like you wanna leave, then do what you do. Baby, you think I'ma cry just because I lost you? Every time I lose one, I bounce back with two. How you think I got you? Somebody got laid out. I'm a pimp, I pimp a chicken until she get played out. Say this, I play this right. Say this, I play this right. Say this, I play this right.
Say this, I play this right. Say this, I play this right. And if you know me,
Shout outs to Ari Lennox, man. Let's get it, man. DC's very own, man. Let's go. What's up? What's up? It's Player Talk Radio. It's DJ Kuda. I am back at the helm of today's show. Got a great show for y'all tonight. Most deaf. All right, we in the building, man. It's Player Talk Radio. I'm in the building. Got a great topic on tonight's show, which is the traveling trick. Is that something you should be doing? Should you be a traveling trick? Like, is it a good idea to say, hey, you know what? Let me go get some out-of-state pussy. Let me...
There's an old saying in Tennessee, I know it's in Texas, probably in Tennessee, that says, fool me once, shame on you. If fool me, we can't get fooled again.
So do you want to travel? Do you want to like, I get it. You know what I'm saying? I think that argument is kind of like what they call a null argument. I believe like if you're like, I don't know where to start on this conversation. Okay, look. Many men have done leaps and bounds to go get pussy. You understand what I'm saying? Many men have, you know, done all kinds of things to get vagina, the vagina with a B, not a V. You know, many men have done so much things, you know what I'm saying, to the point that the guy that doesn't travel to get pussy still know better than the guy that does. You understand what I'm saying? It's one of those things. You understand what I'm saying? But we want to come at this conversation at a logical perspective. We want to come at this conversation like, okay, listen. One will make the argument that the guys that do travel to get pussy, they probably getting some good ass pussy somewhere in some rural ass country, getting a lifetime experience that the nigga that, you know, that's like, man, I can go around the corner and go get this little motherfucker. You know, understand what I'm saying? Sometimes the convenience of something can be your inconvenience of something. So when we talk about this game, what I wanna put forward is, if you're gonna travel to go get some pussy, don't make what you're traveling, like, don't make the trip about the pussy. You understand what I'm saying? That's the trick to it. Not saying that every nigga traveled to get pussy, or I've traveled to get pussy. At some point, every nigga at some point went out of his way to go get some pussy. Nigga, if you went out of your way at least at one time in your life to go get some pussy, nigga, you traveled. Okay? Just think about that. If you went out of your way at some point in your life, you went out of your way. Each footstep you took going out of your way, you traveled. Come on, man. Shit.
There's an old saying in Tennessee. I know it's in Texas, probably in Tennessee, that says, fool me once, shame on you. If fool me, we can't get fooled again.
Come on, man. Anyway. Let's talk about it, man. It's Player Talk Radio, man. How we gonna chop up this game is just, look, man, if you gonna travel out of your way and go get some pussy, don't make the trip be about the damn pussy, man. Like, be actually interested in where you're going and doing different things, learning different dances, eating different types of food, understanding their culture, you know, colloquialisms, like where certain things took place, you know, breathing in the air. Try to envision what history would have been like when you know, when some of those things were going on there, you know, just different kinds of, you know, travel, nigga, you know, like, get on a plane. Go down the runway. Take off. No turning back now. You know, you vertical. You know, you in the air, nigga. Touchdown at LAX. You know what I'm saying? Go to Hawaii. Go to New York. Go to Atlanta. Go to Miami. You know what I'm saying? Go to Chicago. Go to Boston. Pennsylvania. Jersey. You know, touchdown in North Carolina. Do some real shit. Land in JFK. Do anything, my nigga. Just do it. Travel. See the different types of women. Go try mumbo sauce. Go to the club. Jig. Do something, nigga.
Tell you to sit up there and say, explain. You know what I'm talking about, man. He's fighting.
Anyway,
people.
Man.
You know we've been fighting 400 and still fighting to this day. To this day.
We up in the late hours of the night fooling, man. So just travel, man. Go somewhere, you know, enjoy yourself. You know what I'm saying? And if you enjoying yourself, the right type of woman will radiate towards you. And I think you would enjoy your trips a lot more. Just don't make it be about the pussy, man. Then you niggas getting in trouble because then you going into like third world countries and you're just, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, they gonna please the fucking tourists and shit. But them situations be janky, nigga. You still gotta look over your shoulders and shit. You know what I'm saying? And this shit get crazy, man. So don't make whatever you're doing be about pussy. You know what I'm saying? You got to be thinking about other shit. You know what I'm saying? You got to secure the bag. You got to secure the trip. You know what I'm saying? Don't be the type of nigga that like leave out of the country talking about some secure the bitch. No, secure the trip. So if you don't secure the bitch, you not mad about the trip. You had fun. Cause y'all niggas be traveling far to get stood up. Y'all be in some real janky situations, man. I'm telling you, man. I know. Some of my folks travel. I know what be going on. Y'all be in some real janky situations, man. Don't go to Dubai slipping. Them niggas get the bag over in Dubai, son. You go over there in Dubai, nigga. Them niggas.
Yeah, you just sit up there and say, explain. You know what I'm talking about, man. His fighting people. You know we've been fighting 400 and still fighting to this day. To this day. To this day.
Come on, man. You know what I saw earlier today? And they keep putting it on my timeline. YouTube know what they doing, man. Nicole Michelle. She putting out episodes, man. She giving y'all the game, ladies, man. Look, this is what she doing, man. And apparently y'all ladies still having a hard time getting the game. Ain't that a bitch? She giving y'all the game. I told you, you follow Nicole Michelle, you're going to be in a janky situation, man. She talking about being a sugar baby and, oh, having a sugar daddy and, oh, yeah, secure the bag and all that, man. Oh, wait until this episode come out. When y'all see the thumbnail, y'all going to flip. Sometimes more than a little bit. Listen, man, hey. I told y'all she gonna have y'all on some janky shit, man. Y'all gonna be bunned up with some old niggas. Like, that's the best y'all got to come up with, ladies, bro. Hold on, wait. This is just a real big sidebar. Hold on, fuck that. That's the best y'all got. That's the nigga. Oh my God. You know, when you look at your class, just think about your class, right? Like women in your age group, your class, not too older, not too younger and stuff. And you think about like a woman dating a significantly older person and all that other stuff. You know, it makes sense. I'm just saying it makes sense when you factor in life and all that other stuff and stuff. Those relationships make sense. Cool, right? But I'm talking about like your class. Like, what are the people that were in your classroom? Like, what the fuck are they doing right now? Like, do you know how funny, like, the scramble that shit is? Like, nobody's on that same shit you remember in high school, nigga. Life done whooped everyone's ass. Look at us now. You know what I'm saying? Probably doing some shit you never thought you would be doing. Especially the bitches. The bitches got it worse, fellas. I'm telling you, the bitches got it worse. I'm telling you, the bitches got it worse, okay? And a lot of times, they get in the way of themselves, which is the reason why they got it worse, okay? So what I'm saying is that just think about your class in this regard, right? You've heard all the arguments of the, like, a lot of times when you start looking, higher, like, to date somebody a little bit older, like, if life didn't put this on you to date like that, sometimes if you look within your class, it's like, okay, I dominated my class. You know, people on my level, it ain't nothing. You know what I'm saying? Like, when you and when you're like a teenager to like when you're like a young adult, there's a when I do the show tomorrow, I think I have the exact ages for you guys where this happens. And like a lot of us forget about it, but because like life whoops your ass, right? There's this transition that you go through when you're very, very, very young, where you're getting into your like your young adult years, where you go through this transition where you're like really searching for something, I guess, within your class. And then when you feel like you dominated your class, or there's nothing in your class to see that you haven't seen or whatever, you start to go older or younger or something. You know, you start to, you know, look around, or you know what I'm saying? There's like a transition period where that becomes okay with you. But you like you recognize that, okay, this person is older. Okay, this person is younger. You know, you're okay with that. You know what I'm saying? It's not like you just overnight agreed with being okay, or you know what I'm saying? Or sometimes you just didn't think about it. But when you do date people, you do take into account, okay, this person is younger. Okay, this person is older. Or when you get older, you're more aware that the people that you're dating could be younger. You understand what I'm saying? And you could have flavors. You understand what I'm saying? We're getting into some game. So what I'm saying is that the people in your class, it's a scramble. They're gone, you know. Or some, maybe they got a family. Some maybe they chilling. Some maybe a lot of the guys know a whole bunch of dudes that's chilling, but the women, bitches done got pregnant, all kinds of shit. Just all kinds of shit. They don't look the same. Life whoops they ass. And then, guess what happens? You done seen like you've basically seen, I wouldn't say the crux, but you've basically seen the epicenter of, you've basically seen the, I don't know, when you get over what happens, I guess, I don't know how to explain this shit. Y'all, bear with me, y'all. Just see my vision real quick. When you see a empire get taken down, or something that you build up get taken down, like, it's like, damn. Then you start to look at the other generations, and you're like, oh, y'all fucked up too. And then you look at the other generations like, oh, damn, y'all fucked up too. And you like, damn, well, we just fucked up in our own little fucked up different ways. Ain't that something, right? So it's like, you would think if people soaked up the game from the generation before, they could tell you something better than what you already know right now. Like, you can't... Like, I don't know. I don't know. Maybe because my generation ushered in this new technology wave. But it's like, you can't tell no motherfucker, no motherfucking bitch out here to be no goddamn sugar baby. Okay? And let's just talk about something real quick. You cannot tell no bitch that don't think she needs instructions from anybody how to be no goddamn sugar baby, okay? at best, what you're creating is a more slick renegade hoe. What you are creating is a more slick renegade hoe. And when you create this more slick renegade hoe, you know what I'm saying? It's not like she ain't a hoe we ain't seen before. I'm just saying, like, you know, I'm just trying to flow. I ain't even, you know. But anyway, it's like, this, dog, come on, man. Like, this is exactly why MGTOW, SYSBM, Ibmore, and nigga, what, TFL, True Force Lonely Niggas or whatever. Like, this is why these niggas exist. It's like either way you go, it's like, you, dog, I told y'all on the past shows, man, just take a scripture out of the pimp book, man, and just study it and make it work for you, because she'll be more happier around you. I don't fucking know. She'll respect you, whatever, man. Like, the average woman conducts herself like a prostitute, bro. I'm telling you, bro. Like, damn, okay? I'm being 110% with you, bro. Okay? I'm telling you. That's how they conduct themselves. You're going to pay for this, you're going to pay for that. I'm going to pay for this with this. You're going to pay for that and blah blah blah. That's their business savvy. That's why when, you know, women journey is not because she's a hoe or nothing like that. It's because it's really hard for them to think outside of their pussy, bro. It's hard for them. It's really hard. Like, if you are a creature that warrants attention and something is hard to ignore, for some reason you want this attention. You may have use for this attention, you may have not, but you have a want for it. You're not going to zone not too far outside of something that warrants attention itself. As a matter of fact, you're going to study that thing that warrants attention, because you're going to be wondering, why does it get you all this attention? But then you're going to realize that the attention that you're getting is superficial, because this thing warrants so much attention. But then now you're the owner of this thing, and this thing right here can be used for a whole bunch of different things. You know, despite you're going to have conflicting thoughts. That just sounds like a fucking headache right there, bro. Come on, son. Even you as a woman, you know you're not about to get no broads out of there. You know what I'm saying? Like, Nicole Michelle is, like, knowingly, willingly selling y'all a bag of rocks. And y'all are buying them. These are some good-ass rocks. She's giving y'all some game, bro. She's really giving y'all some game. And I see, for some reason, even you hoes, you having a hard time listening to her. Like, let her... whatever pill you know what I'm saying? Whatever pill she passing around, let her do it. Go out there, play some more games, bro. I'm just letting y'all know you leading to the wake up of a whole bunch of different new breed of niggas, man. And that's what I think the manosphere need to concentrate on. These new blue beta males. These blue pill dudes are going to be coming into the space. They're going to be we're going to need a catcher's mitt. We're going to need to have something for them to come over here with that shit with, or else they're going to be spread throwing salt in the game. Because for real, if you familiar with MGTOW and all that other stuff, you already know MGTOW niggas got a whole bunch of trolls. When somebody say they've encountered a MGTOW or met a MGTOW, you know what I'm saying? They most likely met a troll. You have to always be like, well, I doubt you really have met a MGTOW or somebody that's red pill. I doubt. You got to, for you to really know, you have to have certain type of conversations with them or seen certain type of things or, you know about certain types of things. So, you know, that's a whole different thing. Like, when somebody says that, you got to just doubt it at first a little bit. Or until, you know, they prove otherwise. So, and I thought about it. I'm like, you know, why would a whole bunch of MGTOW niggas on the internet be trolls? Like, even if I go into the MGTOW spaces talking the shit that I'm talking, you know what I'm saying? There's some MGTOWs in there. They not talking this shit. So if I go into some MGTOW spaces talking this shit, I will go into criticism by other MGTOWs. You understand what I'm saying? So, you know what I'm saying? But I would still be considered a MGTOW. Does that make sense? So, what would happen is, I wonder, why do MGTOW niggas got these trolls? You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, these trolls are giving a lot of, MGTOW talking points and spaces, like, I guess, a bad rep. You know, just the trolls, you know what I'm saying? How they respond to things, not their actual stance on things. You know, some of these trolls, you can have a real intellectual conversation with them. But I'm not saying go have a conversation with a troll. What I'm saying is that I would be wondering, you know, why would somebody that I know that's smart reply in a certain way or do things in a certain way? And I thought about it. Maybe are they in their feelings or... You know what I'm saying? Or are they, serious? Or are they just joking around? And I thought about it. MGTOW actually have to have a good amount of trolls to keep people away from the real information. I thought about it. And that's why. They have to have a good amount of trolls to actually keep people away from the real information that's being talked about. And that's being discussed. And a lot of, like, black people that, you know, that are in the sector of YouTube, man, you better realize that these conversations that you're listening to, like, right now, you know, you're definitely motherfucking, you're definitely witnessing a good part of history. Because a lot of terms like incel and all this other stuff are making its way into like motherfucking Batman movies and shit. And, you know, you're going to have a new breed of dumbasses that's going to be over here talking about some incel. Because, you know, everybody over here talking about some incel. You're going to have a new breed of dumbasses that's coming over here right now, slinging, like, mudslinging this word around, bro, just for just any insipid dumbass reason. Just for any reason, bro. If they already aren't right now. I'm pretty sure they are right now. I'm like 110% sure they are right now, because I just stay away from some of the shit that I see on this motherfucker, man. The mean YouTube streets pushes on, and I'm gonna be around, bro, for real. So look, man, it's Player Talk Radio. We are in the building. Don't listen to Nicole Michelle. She's selling y'all that good crack, that good shit. She got that good shit though. I ain't gonna lie, she got that good game. She do got that good game. You know, but the answer is not to be a sugar baby, man. You know, getting back to the classism shit, man. Like, go get your older... Why are you getting an older guy that's ready to die? Like, and then going to... come on, man. That's like a really sorry hustle, man. That's a really, really, really sorry hustle. You know what I'm saying? You can get you a sweet lick, but why would you want to know? That nigga at best could just be a good friend. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's not one of them niggas that you, like, maybe you would like him and shit like that, and you maybe would miss his old ass, but you don't miss his old ass. Like, you a special kind of bitch. You a special kind of woman. Like, you real special. Like, yo, what would you do for the bag? Like you would even fake a real friendship. Like, and when that nigga died too, you wouldn't even have felt sorry that he died. You feel sorry that he's gone. And you're like, damn, that's my friend. I'll never see him again. And then that's how you feel your grief. But that's like that slight delayed grief. Like, you made sure, okay, yeah, that's, yeah, the ink dry on that paper right there. Okay, yeah, okay. So, okay. So, something happened to him, the bag's secure, right? Yeah, okay. I'm just making sure, because the last one died and he ain't leaving nothing for me. And that's the one you love and shit. Like, and then y'all retarded too between situations. Like this ain't the first old nigga that died on you and shit. Like, what the fuck? That's all I'm saying, nigga. Like, bitch. Cause think about it. Even securing the bag like that, that's like a special type of way to fucking try to secure the bag. Like, that's unorthodox. That's what I'm saying. You a special type of bitch. If this is the way you gotta secure the bag or try to fake a relationship to feel good about something, come on, man. Come on, man. But I understand it, man. The older guy, he wants the younger, more delicate, more fertile. So I understand, you know, the relationship. But we've seen the dawn of the generation. We've seen the generation fall. We've seen these hoes talk about some pedophiles and all this other shit. And then turn around and date a guy that's in that same age range and then sat up there and talk about some, oh my God, you guys are the worst. You know what I'm saying? You guys, you know, y'all are just some pedophiles. You know what I'm saying? We seen our own women in our own age range talk about some, okay, if you date a younger girl, you're a pedophile. But at the same time, they were dating an older nigga, and that older nigga that was dating them was the same situation that we tried to create with the younger girl. Like, you know what I'm saying? We seen broads sit up there and criticize you for that. And what I'm trying to say is that, you know, damn, bitch. You know what I'm saying? That's the damn, yo, you trying to, see, that's the definition of taking the shortcut. The shortcut ain't wrong with, you know, getting a younger woman and guiding her and cutting, see, that's not a shortcut for a young lady that's worthy. You understand what I'm saying? This the game. That's not a shortcut for a young lady that's worthy. If you an older dude and you reach back to, first of all, help her. First of all, guide her, but not only help her and guide her, meet her at her prime years, right? Give her and use your resources to shorten her time in her prime. You're going to shorten her time in her prime and guide her in the right direction to get the things that she wants. You understand what I'm saying? And it has to be that way. In a lot of cases, unless, you know, she already come into the situation like that. Some women try to, well, I'll meet you there. You know what I'm saying? Oh, I ain't gonna make you in charge of my time. That's what she's basically saying. See, because any woman could come by and use you. You'll do. This will do. That's you. You will do. So what I'm saying is that, you know, She's not gonna let you. That's what it is. Is no matter what she's using her resources for. Sometimes you got a leech. You got a girl that's okay. She really not doing shit. Okay, she said she was a model or she was doing this, that, and the third. Bitch hasn't gone to one open mic. Bitch hasn't gone to one poetry slam session. Bitch hasn't gone to. She hasn't done nothing. She's not really pursuing her career. And I'm taking some of the load off of her with having a relationship with her. And we splitting shit and doing shit like y'all have a relationship. Yes, nigga, bunned up together. Bottom da, boot up, bottom da, boot up, like shit. You know what I'm saying? Come on, man. It is late at night. And we are up bullshitting after Mimosa Monday. So what I'm saying is that, you know, if you watch that Redskins game and you thought you got it, right? And you could taste it, like the victory was in your mouth, and then niggas come back and lose. And it gives you the blues. So it's like, you know, look at the Redskins, man. The Redskins been fucking up. Like, come on, man. Y'all don't get it? Like, nigga, that's been the Redskins' problem the whole time. Why don't you be the sneak-up team? Stop waiting for them to sneak up on you. No, you're not leading the game. You've never led the game for years. Y'all never held on to it. You had it, and then you lost it. That's the worst. Nigga, that's the for real. Redskins fans deserve special type of insurance. Because that's the worst way to experience a loss. Like, you have it, and then you just lose it. That's fucked up. That's the fucked up part. That's a special kind of fucked up. So what I'm saying is that, you know, you sneak up. That's how you do it. You know? Look up the Chad Dukes rant. That was one of the... Bro, man. Anyway, I don't know why I'm talking about the Redskins. Anyway. It's the same with y'all renegade hoes, man. Y'all renegade hoes. No, you didn't have it, bro. You're north of 35 with kids. Kids. You're north of 35 with kids. Baby girl, stop. Stop. For the sake of you and your kid, stop. The best thing you can do is get your children under control. Get you under control. Date. This motherfucker is never around you and your kid. If anything, he'll probably see, like, maybe your kid's toys just somewhere, or pictures or something. That's why motherfuckers had pictures hung up in their house. People don't really got pictures of their kids like that. You don't really see pictures of people, kids like that, hung up in their house like that anymore, man. You see their kids on their phone and shit. You understand what I'm saying? This my daughter. Oh, okay. Yeah, that my daughter. Damn, bitch, you retarded. You know what I'm saying? You don't really see people with pictures of their kids hung up in their house. Sometimes you do, but, you know, not like that. Anyway. We in this joint, man. It's Player Talk Radio, man. We got a show coming on tonight. I gotta choose a topic. I got a hat that I ripped up some paper and I put it in the hat. And I'm gonna be picking topics out of this hat right here. So, I'm not even on screen. Anyway. And I don't feel like reaching over to pick this thing up and come up on screen. Because I'm actually doing this podcast laying down. Okay. So, anyway. What I'm going to say is, tune in, man. It's Player Talk Radio. We in this joint. Let's go.
Now, you know you got to break the game down a little bit more. Because they might be slow.
Let's get it.